It all began there. I met him at the end of the road. He was lying there with his eyes wide open, as if waiting for something to happen. I saw him. Frightening as he was, his face was covered with mud. Running was the first reaction thought that came to my mind. So I tried to run past of him, only to realize to my horror that I could run no more. I tried to ignore him and pretended not to see him. I pretended he was not there. But he was too powerful to be ignored. Too powerful. He drove me to himself. I realized soon that he couldn't or wouldn't go away. He was there to stay. Too powerful to ignore. I had not asked for this. I had an ordinary life, a life of my own, one that I cherished and cared for. But now, with him there, everything had changed. I was no longer in charge of me. He had now moved to the upper floor of my house, was busy transforming my home, making it more comfortable. So now there were me, him, and the pain between us, hunting me wherever I was placed. The man was counting my steps. He was a reminder of a life I could not afford, and a life I could not command. So I started to run again. To run faster and more accurate. My running had a history. He told me later that I was only pretending to run, that I was not running at all. At all. He told me that I was standing all the time, as if running. As if running. But who was running if it wasn't me? Was there someone else running in place of me? Something had come to light that should have been hidden. My eyes opened to a puzzling night. Me and him. Me or him. That was the question. One of us had to run. Whether it was me or him, neither of us knew. But one of us decided to get rid of the other. This was planned ahead to be the end of our companionship. The end.
Thank you.
So I started to tell him that. Or was it him telling me? This was a confusing night. I told him that I did not need him, that I could go on with my life without him counting my steps or seeing me everywhere and always. Didn't I have a right to a life of my own? Was I not entitled to my freedom and enjoyment? What was this? I asked him questions the entire night, the entire night. I asked him and he replied only with his silence. It was killing me. I tried to convince him that he should leave me alone, that he could find someplace else to grow. So it was then that I told him about my plan. I told him that by the end of this night, one of us had to leave the other. And I sure as hell had no intention to go anywhere. This was my home, and I wanted to keep it that way. He was just an intruder. But my challenger would just look me in the face and laugh. It was annoying. The whole night passed with me trying to convince him. Nothing gave result. Sometimes he would open his mouth and spoke to me, but with very short and incoherent sentences like, "What did I tell you?" or "Have I not warned you?" or "Aren't you tired?" But I never really gave up. I felt that I still had to fight for my life. I dreamt about a life far away from him. I longed for my freedom. Can a man exist without freedom? When did I become like this? I remember a story my mother told me once. The story was about a man who moved to the village together with his family long before I was born. The man had a happy life with his wife and children. The villagers said that one day the man got mad and never became himself again, following a period of sickness. They said, my mother told me, that the evil had changed places with him, that he was no longer him and never became himself either. Was this my period of sickness? Was I about to change my place with his? This was a horrific night. Thank you. I was no longer aware of time. The concept was corrupted long before this night. But tonight it had lost weight and yet gained a new definition. Only a few hours were left to the dawn, to the end of our companionship, to the end of this mess. He was there to destroy me. Annihilation. That was his mission, his target. And I was his prey. During our discussions, he said something strange to me. He told me that he did not exist. That I had created him. He was, of course, mad and talking nonsense. He had no idea what he was talking about. This was wild talk. How could I give essence to something that deprived me of my own existence? Who tried to annihilate me? He was suffocating me, and I could breathe no more. Was he right? Was he about to take over me totally? Was he winning? It was then that I arrived at my decision. I prepared myself for the final battle. Though he had the upper hand, I still thought I had a good chance of survival. Survival, wasn't it what it was all about? I felt that he knew it too. He knew that the final battle was in sight. And he knew that not both of us could get out of the field alive. I heard his whistling. He was calling upon me to join him. He was waiting for me in the next room. This was the final war. He was more prepared than I thought. Something that gave me horrible feelings. When I entered the site, he was already there, sitting where I used to sit, in my chair, in my room. Who was this guy, and how dared he? I sought refuge in my room ahead of the night's confrontation. I heard him in the other room, working on his stack. I was unaware of his strategy, yet I knew that his confidence could get him to win the battle. He seemed unafraid of the interface. This was by all means the most decisive encounter one could be part of during a lifetime. Destinies were being made, and lives were being destroyed tonight. He was silent as he always was. He was only whistling, as he always used to. I tried to talk sense into his head and began speaking to him in a soft tone. I told him about my life. I told him that I was a lonely man owning nothing on the entire earth. There are better people, richer people, he could deal with. I, on the other hand, was a worthless creature, I told him. He could learn nothing from me. He was watching me with a mocking smile on his indifferent face. God, I hated him. But I did not give up. I still thought if I could pursue him that I was not worth it, he would let me go. When I realized that he would be unaffected by my story, I was left with no options. Then I started to swear at him, calling him names for what he was worth. I told him that I was not afraid of him. You think I'm afraid of you, you ugly monster? You think I'll sit back and watch you destroy me, you son of an idiot? I'll show you the real world. Welcome to my world. I have no fear. This was the last time I saw him alive. Who was taking shower? Who was left in the room? Was the battle over? Was that all? Was I me? Did he survive? This was the best shower I so far had experienced. I was in intense searching for the truth. What had just happened here? Who was carrying whom? Who was burying whom? Me or him? Me and him? Who did this to me? Who was behind this? Tell me, who did this to me? Who was behind this?
Thank you.
He resembled me so much after all. God, I wanted to know who this guy was.
Taken in a garden long before the war, and out on the lawn there were old men and dogs and little children, all of them gone forever. And there were people by the waterside, standing in the same place where I am today. Nothing has changed, but you know that time is moving like a river. It can only be love forever. Gone.